Hello everybody, welcome to A Tale of Spices. Thai food is something which is very similar to our Kerala kind of dish, where you know they use a lot of coconut milk in their stews and their gravy vegetables. So I'm going to make a yellow Thai curry today, and this is going to be like a quick version of it with the ingredients that are readily available with you at home. So for that, what I'm doing is I'm taking a pan. I'm going to put in just a little bit of oil. Don't need much oil. Actually, this can be a very healthy meal option. So I've just taken very little oil. I have some sliced onions. So I'm just going to put that in. I have here blanched vegetables. So I have a mixture of broccoli, cauliflower, baby corn, capsicum and carrot. You can use any vegetable that you like. You can use zucchini, you can use squash, you can use any of those vegetables also. So I have these vegetables. These have been cut and blanched in hot water for almost 4 to 5 minutes. So they are like 3/4 cooked, but it still has that crunch in it. So I'm just going to put some salt to the onion. Just a pinch of salt to the onions so it sweats out. I just want the raw flavor to go away. I don't want it to become too soft. So it's just going to take 1 minute. So the onions have become pink and translucent now. So I'm going to add all the vegetables into it now. Give one stir. You can see how colorful the whole thing is. It's really beautiful. Okay. So to this, I'm going to add 1/2 teaspoon of, or 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder. This is what is going to give you the yellow color for the yellow Thai curry. So I've added 1/2 spoon of turmeric powder. I have here, I made a paste of green chili, ginger, garlic, and a little bit of lemon zest in it. So this is just a simple paste which I made at home with a little bit of vinegar in it. So I'm adding that to it. And give it a quick mix, the whole thing. Now, since all the vegetables are already boiled, you don't need to cook it too much. It just has to heat through, so it's just going to take 2 minutes. So now I'm adding 1 cup of coconut milk. Half a cup of water. I have to adjust the salt, but before that I have to add one key ingredient, which is peanut butter. Now if you have crunchy peanut butter or smooth peanut butter, whichever you have, you can use that. If you do not have peanut butter, while you're making the paste with the green chili, the garlic, the ginger and everything, you can add peanuts to it also and make the paste. So, you know, it will give you that nice peanut crunchy taste. So, I'm adding 2 big tablespoons of peanut butter to it. This is yum. I love peanut butter. And mix it in. And once it's mixed in, you just have to check for the salt seasoning and adjust the salt to it. So I need to put a little bit of extra salt in it because it is a little on the lower side of its salt. So I'm adjusting the seasoning for the salt, and it has to be mixed. And you see these bubbles formed, and you see also that, you know, it's starting to thicken up. So let's eat. This is that simple. It can be done in 5 to 6 minutes if you have all the vegetables blanched and kept ready. To add to the protein flavor, You can also add tofu or paneer to it and make it like a really healthy one. Either way, you know, this is definitely a very healthy option, and you can eat it even when you are on a diet. And you can team it up with some brown rice, as I'm going to do it today. So this is done, actually. So you see it's bubbling up, it's cooked, and I'm going to switch it off and I'm going to plate it up. So there you have it. I have served the Thai yellow chili curry with some brown rice, and I'm just garnishing it with just a little bit of mint on it, and top it up with some crushed roasted peanuts just for that extra added crunch. And you can serve this up with some boiled noodles also. So try it out sometime, and I'm sure you would really love it. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much for watching.